Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Star Sector. Last time, we managed to muddle our way through certification and teamwork, and we didn't quite manage to do exercise Apple Party. There's a lot more stuff here to do, actually. I thought I'd give Apple Tree Garden Party. I thought I'd give Apple Tree another go. And yes, apparently, it wasn't actually a bug, it was part of the mission. I wasn't reading this as much as I should have. I am not the actual captain of this mission, which is why the AI was dating things. Apparently the same is true for, I think, Soldier of Fortune. One of these as well also has it so that you are not actually the commander of the mission, you're just there. Anyway, one of the things I wanted to do and think about was basically getting some points back, getting that away, and installing Front Shield Emitter. And, okay, how much is hardened shield? 12. Okay, hardened shields I can't get away with. I think it's way too much. But if I put in a front shield emitter, that increases my shield arc to something considerable, which means if I lower it, hopefully that effect happens together with the... If that stacks with the shielding, it means I'll get my twin shield layer at 90%, 90 degrees, which should be much more useful. At the same time, I think I'm going to get rid of these. I'm not a huge fan of these. Let's change it for something else. Let's see, what can I put in here? It needs to be, what, about 5 points maximum. So let's think about 5 points. Coasting Missile Rex is 4. Thrasos is actually, that's not. I want to see if I can stick to the Psy weapons, so... Any other sort of Psy missile packs? The coasting missile rack is there. Cluster torpedo rack is the Psy one. I don't think anything else here is Psy based. No, I think the only Psy ones are here. So okay, we'll stick with the cluster torpedo racks. I'm not a huge fan of them, but we'll see what we can make them work. And there. Right. Let's see if that works out for me. See if that functions. See if that actually has a good effect for us. Alright, play mission. Let's try this one more time. One more time. With feeling. Capture orders there and there. If I turn that on... Okay, that's 90 degrees. I'm okay with that. It means I actually got some speed and some range now. Right, I have no idea if this is actually going to work out in the end, but it does mean that I can actually tank some shots with a shield that can actually deal with it. I'm going to stick together with my other Lamia buddy here. Hopefully we can together make use of something. Frankly, I don't know. Frankly, I do not know. We'll have to see what we can do. What we can do to make this count, make this useful. Right, see if you can get over there. Get some fire out. Okay. Right, so you got a full... The problem, of course, with the shield is the lack of... you don't dissipate fucks if the shield's up. I don't think. Okay. The Mergera is down, unfortunately. Okay, so what's the... where am I? I am over here. Can I make my way over to the Condors? Can I make my way over to the Condors? That is a lot. That is a lot of salamanders. Okay, it's a lot of salamanders. Engines are back online though. Good. So we can get those Condors out of commissions. Talus is out of missiles. Okay, fine. Garion is gonna go down. Garion is down. Okay, that's something at least. I really need to vent really quite badly, and now I'm in serious trouble. And again, this thing has no armor, so even talons can now screw me over horribly. Good. Come on, point defense. Come on, point defense, do your job. Wow. Come on, do something. I'm still not overly impressed by this, to be honest. Yep, even a talon can take me down. Fair enough. I'm not overly impressed with that. Let's move on to mission 4, shall we? Before I get overly annoyed at this mission again. Exercise garden party. Manticore is your only carrier. Keep it out of harm's way. Siren can pull ships from afar, but lacks the firepower to destroy them. The Calcatoire has to do that. Okay, there's definitely something wrong here, because we haven't got a Siren or a Calcatoire. This is basically... all this stuff is written before the massive Psy update. So... it says, the Manticore is your only carrier. Okay, fair enough, that's there, that's true. Sirens can pull ships from afar. I haven't got a Siren. Calcatoroi do have that firepower. We haven't got one of those. We got a Drain A-class combat cruiser, a Korokota, Erythmanthium Boar, and a couple of Lamias, a couple of Electos. Yeah. This is definitely done from before the patch, the big update. This is definitely from the before the big update. Let's try this out. So what I've actually got? I got Orion Artillery, which is... that's a cool one. It speeds up the more I fire it. At long range, I think it is kinetic, and at close range, it's high explosive. Then you have a lot of high explosive... okay, good. Then secondary thrusters. I like secondary thrusters. We've got some distance to do. Okay, so this is fairly interesting. This is the interesting one, because this now... I think this is the cruiser that was... highlighted in the tournament as being very, very nice for broadsides. Getting some really beautiful broadsides off. Okay, so we're going to capture those nav boys, etc, etc. We have already got a nav boy, it's good. Make a move over, shall we? Some nice shots off with this Orion artillery. Okay, let's get it. There's the Gemini over there. Let's work on the Gemini, shall we? Let's get closer to this thing. Auxiliary thrusters up and running. Let's see what this can actually do. A lot of... I have to vent because there was a lot of... a lot of flux efficiency issues here. A lot of flux efficiency issues here. Alright. Even my active venting isn't that great at the moment. So there's a high explosive mortar Mark 1 and Mark 2. And a kinetic Mark 1 and Mark 2. You can see these are the Mark 2s over here, these are the Mark 1s. The Electo is taking damage over there. I'm playing up here and I don't know why. I definitely want to take air of these carriers though. I think, is he backing out? He might be backing out. Let's turn around and see if he can deal with this Eagle. I like the Orion. The Orion's, like, thematically, it's very interesting. Look at that broadside turn as well. Come on, can you get some fire, please? Look at that, look at those broadsides, look at those broadsides. That is a thing of beauty. That is definitely a thing of beauty. And I'm venting and everyone's decided to go, hello! Harpoon crazy. Okay, let's not try that again. My venting is exceedingly bad. Let's see what we can do to fix that. My flux dissipation is ridiculously bad. Let's reduce that immediately and start working on that. Definitely working on improving that. Let's move with your iron artillery, because I like it thematically, but I definitely think it's far more useful to have some of that up to increase the active flux dissipation, because that was horribly bad. I got 17 to play around with. I can go high explosive more. I can go zone scorcher, which is a point defense weapon. We'll give that a go. Weapon groups. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to try this out. I'm going to control the zone scorcher for some bizarre reason. But let's give this a go. Someone asked if the whole point of these missions is to do it with the loadout you're given. It's like, well, if that was the case, then why do I have the option to refit? Especially in the situation of the Psy, where these missions actually hadn't been visited since the massive rebalance update. So that's not entirely true. Not for this specific one, anyway. Right. I want to see how well this Zone Scorcher will do against the fighters. I'm going to be controlling it myself, which is the interesting part. But I want to see how well this does against the fighters. Because this should be tearing fighters to pieces. Oh, shields up. There's a lot of stuff over here. Let's get some missiles. Your missiles being destroyed already. Okay, let's see what we can do over here. Come on. Good. The Talon Wing's already down. Which is more than we had last time, so already an improvement. Good Talon Wing over there as well. Ooh, I don't even know what you're called anymore. What are you called? You're the Irimanthian Boar. The Irimanthian Boar's already on low. Okay. Definitely designed to take out missiles more than fighters, but still, keeping the fire up is also very interesting. Like, thematically, Lamia is already down, is low down. Okay, so if we can get into this Gemini, what will this do? Taking a lot of the drones down. Oh, this is actually good. This actually looks pretty damn decent. We got some fire into this thing. I think that's an ion beam. Yeah, that's an ion beam. Hey, but that's way better than we had last time. I'm not entirely sure about the Orion artillery. Thematically, I love it. In practice, I think it's not enough. There's another Gemini up there. Another Gemini up there. I want my Zone Scorcher back online. It's okay, it's online again. Good. Let's go catch up to this thing, shall we? All its point defense drones go down as well, which is an interesting bit. Good. And this thing now, without any armor to its name, it will do a lot of damage. Good. Turn off our... Lecto is down, but that's... Okay, much better. Carrier's down. Still very bad venting. But it's something, nonetheless. We actually got something out of this. I'm happier with this than I have been for a lot of time. Okay, some damage from shots out. Here we go. We got a hammerhead to deal with now. Lamia is... Secondary thrusters, let's get closer to this thing. Shields down. I don't have to. Come on. Good. Vent while I can. Okay, it's a bit of a mess. But much improved as to last time. The Aranthian Boar is still up, but I can at least do some damage. Right, let's get behind some things and start working on them. Definitely keep it worried. We'll definitely be keeping it worried. Alecto's down, yep, unfortunately. But we're getting progress here. Except if this happens. That is going to be inconvenient. Because that's a lot of high explosive damage. Kinetic damage that I can't afford to deal with. But we got progress. Okay, we're going to shoot shields down. Shields down and start hitting it on the side now. Luckily, the Zone Scorcher can afford to fire consistently. So... Look, unfortunately those... Okay, here we go. We can back out for a bit, which is really bad because he's just dashing forwards now. But not that bad, actually. Not that bad. I can put my shields up again and start firing off again. I'm dueling 1v1 against these things, but it's actually not as bad as I thought it was going to be. Come on. Get some damage in there. Make it vent or something. Here you go. It doesn't have to vent. If it doesn't have to vent, we can just keep shooting it in the face. Alright, my shields need to go down really soon, otherwise I'm going to start having trouble. Beautifully done. Okay, so that's a lot of... stuff that's gone our way right now. I'm going to turn around and I'm going to deal with those guys. The Zone Scorcher is actually turning out to be a lot more useful than I was expecting. Let's go for you, I think, because you're already low health. You got low... Ooh, I know, or you as well. If I distract you from your friend over there... I'm going to have to turn off the shields soon enough, but turning off the shields will be okay because now I've got the advantage here, I think. I'm the one dealing damage to his face. He's the one that has to focus with to ignoring me. And my weapon's actually quite low flux, which means I can just sit quietly, sit happy, and let him deal with whatever trouble comes my way. Good. And let's just do some shots out with this Zone Scorcher, which is actually really, really useful. I'm surprised about the Zone Scorcher. It's probably not useful as the AI. The AI probably using it as an AI ship, I mean. Using it as a main weapon, because it'll get tried to use it as an assault cannon, which is not really what it was supposed to do. I'm using it because I'm the one piloting the ship. So I'm the one going there, okay, let's get into its face and make sure... that this flak just does a lot of damage. It does saturate point defense a lot as well. It's like having point defense exploding in their face. So if they fire any missiles at you, the missiles immediately go down. But not a bad start. What's left? There's a couple of Sunders left, and the Eagle itself. The Manticore's still alive, so that's a blessing. I think we can just go ahead and sit in its face for a bit. Shields up, of course, because of that. It's going to be an interesting test, because it's going to be a test of the Sabos. What happens with the Sabos? So I'm thinking at some point it's going to try to fire Sabos at me. I think we're okay, actually. Oh, there we go. They got past its shielding, and rocket shots to the side. Good. Quick vent. Second Sunder, and then the Eagle, and we're done. It's quite a nice change of pace, I think. Much better, I think. I wasn't a huge fan of that Orion. Like I said, thematically, I think the Orion is awesome. I think you need several of them. I don't think one Orion is enough. I think one Orion is too much Jack of all trades, master of none. Assuming that, yeah, that died, so just that Eagle left, really. Right, okay. Okay. Okay, the red French ruby. Let's start getting shields up. That thing got low. Okay, that's good. It's got zero CR, so that's a blessing in disguise. That thing's dead, pretty much. All I need to keep is focus on it for a bit. And this is probably dead now, just to main. I can probably stop firing, because now I've got like high explosive mortars coming in, which is doing a lot of damage. The high explosive mortars are doing more damage than anything else, but any armor they clear is damage for me. 49%, but it's a win. It's probably the smoothest win I've had playing as this in these Psy missions. Let's do one more today. What was the one after this one? It was Red Vine. Red Vine, okay, you're fighting a conquest, but that's not the point. We're not trying to do a conquest. We're trying to fight as. So okay, this is the interesting one. Fruit salad. It's a hard mission. What have you got? We got ourselves a Siren. Breton de Finois. And the lasagna, which is the Kalkotaroi, Erymanthian boar, which these have radar pings and MRM arrays, and laser torpedo pods and rocket pods. You've got, of course, your gamma ray radiation reactor. What have I got? I've got the teleporting shell and the Brontios weapons. We can give those a go. Let's see what happens. Okay, what have I got? This is, of course, the Siren, which we all know is basically a massive shot. It just fires a massive kinetic damage weapon. Again, the animations on these things are glorious. There's a teleporting shell as well. There's a teleporting shell. If I shoot a ship with a teleporting shell and it hits armor or hull, I believe. It doesn't work if it hits shields. Have to hit armor or hull. I've also got defense alternators and KX and high H explosive mortars. Let's get some shots in, shall we? I'll definitely take that shot. That's a beautifully powerful shot, actually. Let's focus on getting some shots out on you. Yep, nice shot there. There is a Karkotta with... What have you got? An armored Karkotta as well. Can I target you? Okay, you've got an Ultra HV Energy... something or other. Right, let's focus on... getting some shots out, shall we? Alright, let's focus on hitting you. And again... And again. And again. Nice big shot. Oof. And teleporting shot. There you go. That's what the teleporting shell does. If it hits the hull, it teleports it close to you. Let's try this out, shall we? Teleporting shot. I pulled its armor away. Interesting. Let's get some shields between you and your friends. To be expected, I suppose, but still interesting nonetheless. To be expected, but interesting nonetheless. Okay, so it's hitting the front of the Corcotta here. Critical malfunction to its front armor. A lot of EMP damage on this thing. Talos. Okay, let's quickly do a quick venting. Right, Kalkotaroi, you're gonna fire your beam. Okay, good. Let's see if we can get a good shot off on this thing. Nope, hit the wrong one. Nice shot on the side there. Beautiful shot on the side, actually. This is actually a really decent ship now. I say now, like as if it wasn't before. But definitely a beautiful sight to see. And it fires beautifully as well. And I do like a big... I like a ship built around a weapon that works well. Notice that works well. This thing does the job it's supposed to do quite nicely. Far more efficiently, I think, than the Imperium. That Imperium Dreadnought. That had a sniper sledge weapon. Kayak. I hit shield. That was a teleporting shot that hit the shield. Pick vent. Luckily, those beehive nailers are all fragmentation damage, so I don't have to worry about too much of them if they hit me at the moment. Overloaded, and probably going to die to the next shot. Yep, that'll do. Enemy Garion disabled. Enemy Draconade disabled. Do you have no shields? That's actually my... Okay, you do have a shield. Well, I wonder why you aren't using yours. Something clearly over there is more important to shield against than me. Oh dear lord. No. My bad. You moved in front of me. This thing has a delay between firing and... Good. Talos destroyed. Shot into its side. This is a non-armored Corcotta. Can you get a teleporting shot into this thing? Yes, you can. At which point all my weapons just open fire. That's actually really interesting. I fire a teleporting shot, at which point all my weapons open fire on this thing. Really quite beautifully. Can we get a teleporting shot? Ah, no. Rough. I want to get a teleporting shot. That was really, really nice. That was beautifully done. 100% for that. That was really done, and without even changing anything. I want to try this again. Because I want to try that in the... both of these. I want to fly the Erymanthian Boar and the Kalkotta Roy. I want to see what it's like. Right. So this thing has... What have you got on you? Secondary thrusters, which we know we've got. Rocket pods, which we know we have as well. 32 rockets. But you have the gamma ray radiation thing, which is the beam. Can I actually hold it? I can hold it active. Interesting. And of course I have the pods here. The more pods I have, the more damage I do. Okay, so it's secondary thrusters. Let's try doing some damage with this thing. I also want to see if the siren can do anything as good as I did, because the siren... that siren was beautifully done. Okay. Let's lower my shields down. Can I keep firing on this thing? I can definitely keep... Hello. I'm not going to complain. This is really, really good. Okay, there you go. That's better. I'm taking fire from something, but it's turning its shield to face something else. Ooh. Those kayaks are also really useful because they're forcing it to keep its shields away, and beautiful, now we can vent. That was really beautiful. Kalkatori did, of course, did sterling work for the Psy factions in the tournament. It's actually got a really fast beam startup time as well. I've not been a fan of the small ships, but these ships have definitely sparked my interest. It's even doing decent damage to the shields. Hello. Hello. Very much liking this, by the way. Very much liking this. It's turning around to give me this, to give me the other armor, but it gave up halfway through. Okay, we'll vent you, and then we'll go fly one of the other ones. Let's go fly you, because you're in combat at the moment. See what we can do with you. But that I found very awesome. Yeah, it's going to overload. It's going to die really soon, unfortunately. Yeah, I'm not sure. Right, let's go that one instead. That's about to die. Oof, gotta like that though. I just saw a little bit of missile spam and it made me happy. Okay, hello, what have we got? What have we got to work with here? We have ourselves a light tech vehicle defense system, which is a beam laser, okay. Radar ping, that's fine. Auto-nailers, okay. So, MRM in range, right? Lock on? Fire MRM. Oh, that's beautiful. Fair enough. Unlikely to hit that thing. That thing's got two Beehive auto-nailers firing. Laser torpedo pods up at the front, so it can go boom-boom. Oof, still hit hard. Hello! Like, that's still useful. Massive fire! Oh! Beautifully done! And get some firing in as well. Laser torpedoes is very, very nice. Oh, my word. Okay, I haven't been that keen on the frigates and the destroyers, but these cruisers are godly. I am a huge fan of the cruisers. Okay, so what would be the next mission? This was a really nice mission. Apparently it's hard. Again, I'm not sure if the balance is up to par. Then we have a mousetrap. Catch the traitor. Catch a single Tisiphone inside a Margera and a Lelaps. Yeah, we'll give that a go. Come on. It's 32 minutes, but it's Friday today, so let's go have some fun. It says beware of collisions. So we're here. Let's lock on to the target and let's go chase. Let's go chasing. Okay, shields definitely have to be off for this, I think. Okay, I'm running at about 240 now. It's about 200 and a bit, so we can catch up to this thing. Of course, not that easy, I'm afraid. Safety switch is what? Weapon use plus weapon output, range reduced. Okay, so it's a switch. Okay, so what I actually got weapons-wise? K-Ax. Okay, weapon 3,500 is the range. 3,500 is the range. I'm definitely going faster than you are, mate. So, I should be catching up to you. 2,400. 2,300. 3,200. 2,800. 2,700. 2,600. 2,500, 2,400, 2,300, 2,200. Range is gonna be... Okay, we've got a lot of things to go still. Sadly, we gotta go in the middle of a nebula. That's not what I wanted. Oh god, the collision. It's pulling ahead again. Oh, come on, this thing's... Okay. So, we're at 2,300. And closing. 2,000. Okay, it's turned around. Shields up. Good, it's here. Get some shots on it. Get some shots on it. Get some shots on it. It's out of missiles, but it's flamed out, so we're okay. Clivent, we've caught up to it now. All it needs to do is now. All we need to do is kill it now. There you go. Oof. Oof. That's a fun little end to the mission today. That was Mousetrap. What would the next one be? The next one would be Whack-A-Mole, then the Soldier of Fortune, then there's War Games. I might do a extra special episode at some point, just to to knock these out this week. But that was awesome. The Siren was, hang on, let me look at these things up. So the Siren Brontios is a very, very nice kinetic damage. Up to 2000 AP damage per hit, bypasses shields if at high hard flux. Long range artillery that propels various ordnances. Also has a teleporter shell. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful weapon. And has this got a, it's got a flight deck as well. I like this very, very much. Kokotoroi has the rocket pods, has auto nailers, has of course the gamma radiation, which is energy damage. So it's 400 DPS usually, but per active module, which has got six, it's an extra 100 energy DPS, but with extra 100 flux. So at full operation, this is dealing 1,000 energy DPS for 1,000 flux a second, which is actually a fairly efficient beam. It's a one-to-one efficiency beam. It's got 600 flux dissipation, so it's not too bad at all. I like it as well. Very, very nice. And you guys have, of course, the MRM array built in, which is the... I think Boar fires a standard regenerating missiles equipped with a shield. Piercing high-density tip. It's a kinetic missile. Allows for 360 degrees of coverage with a swarm of light missiles that otherwise not to ignore. Very, very nice indeed. And it reloads. Beautifully done. It fires 90 shots a minute. But then again, that's not saying much. Beautifully done. I like it very much indeed. And this one was in the light vehicle defense system is a point. It's a medium beam point defense. Okay. LVDS. Livids. Okay. Okay. It's a one-to-one efficiency, decent range point. It's a point defense beam. It's a medium point defense beam. It's a, basically a medium-sized PD laser. Fair enough. And you had a KAC instead, but you had a rocket pod Mark III's. If I quickly hop into this, it's 38 minutes, but we'll just come on just a bit further. I'm gonna see that is beautiful. I have a huge love of missile spam, as some of you might be aware. Okay, so hang on. Let me just quickly change this. If I go into weapon groups, I can group that into four. That into three, those into two, alternate them, and then I can actually mess around with this. Let me give us off. I haven't got the bloody point targeting things. Right, let's give us something quick and easy to destroy. Simple. Something I can just attack without having to worry about it. Dominator D, that'll do. So I've got these. Are these actually guided at all? Let's find out. Okay, they are guided to a certain degree. So if I put this on auto fire... Very, very nice indeed. Very, very nice indeed. Okay, I'm aware this is the Dominator D, but just being able to sit in front of it and just wreck it like this is very, very nice indeed. I am a huge fan of missile spam. And of beam spam. Oh, anyway. 40 minutes, long episode, guys. I'll get you all next time. See you then. Bye.